Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. So today's 3D modeling tool is Poke Polygons. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how it works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. The very first thing I'm going to do is come over to my primitives and I'm going to add in a cube. I'll change my display mode to garage shading with lines so that we can see our lines. And in our object manager, we'll increase our segments to about 5 for all of these. And you can hit the C hotkey or click this button here and it will make this parametric object into a polygonal object. So we'll click that right there. And something that I wanna do just in order to show what's happening here is I'm going to go into point mode. You can see point mode is right here. And I'm going to increase the size of my selection with my right bracket key, select all these points. Select this point here, select this point here. Now I know we haven't covered this tool yet and we will in the future, so no worries right now. We're going to use U to bring up the modeling hotkeys and Z for melt. And it'll make that side of our cube a n-gon, and an n-gon has more than 4 edges. A quad has 4 edges. As you can see over here, we have quads on this side. This side is an n-gon because we have more than 4 edges here. And we're going to go into how Poke Polygons works, and you'll see you can find it up here. Under add, you can see our adding 3D modeling tools and you can see Poke Polygons here. And you'll notice that there actually aren't any hotkeys for it. But what I like to do is if I'm going to be using that 3D modeling tool, I like to use the hotkey Shift C in order to bring up the command manager and then look for Poke Polygons. And I can see it's right here and we can drag and drop it over here to the side. And now it's there if we need it. If you want to save this layout, you can click this plus button here and you can save it as your startup layout or you can save your layout as a specific name. I've created some different layouts up here. And you'll notice that this icon comes with a gear over here. And that's because you can actually click on that and see some additional options in here, such as offset and select vertices. But for right now, let's just go over the basics of what this tool does. So it will create a point in the center of your polygon, and that goes for both quads and n-gons. You can use this tool in polygon mode and edge mode, and I'll go over how they work a little bit differently. Just as an example to show how it'll create a point in the center of an n-gon, I'll go ahead and click it right here. And you'll see we've made a point in the center of here and it's connected all of those points along the edges. So that is one way you can use the tool in polygon mode. It works very similarly if you click on a quad, and you can click on multiple quads actually, and hit this button here and it will make a point perfectly in the center, similar to the add point tool, which we went over previously, and I'll leave a link to that in the description below in case if you'd like to learn more about how to add points to your models. And our next option that we could do in here is, let's open up some of these settings. So I'm going to click this button here and you'll see we have an offset button. So let's make this 5 inches, hit OK. And now it has created a point and it's also extruded that point So if you are working on a leather jacket and you'd like to 3D model some studs on it, this is one way you could go about it, really easy and simple. And then our next option in here, I'll click on some more polygons as an example. I'll open up this right here. You'll notice we have this option to select vertices. So this time I'll turn that on, and what it'll do is it'll select our vertices so that we can then use them in point mode. Right now we're still in polygon mode. I'll hit OK. And initially you won't see that our points are selected, but if you switch over from polygon mode to point mode, you can see that our points here are all selected. And that could come in handy if you know you're going to need to edit these afterwards. If you're going to use these points for something else in the future, you can go up to select store selection and it'll save a point selection for you to use in the future. So it's very powerful. Our next option here is I just like to show that this tool also works in edge mode. So if you want to use it in edge mode, select the edges of where you would like to poke the polygons, I guess, would be the term. And we'll click this button here, and there you have it. You have some more right over there. So it gives you some control over your 3D modeling. And just to try something for fun, I'm going to use UZ again, and we're going to try adjusting the settings here. Maybe I'll try 10. I'll hit OK. Oh, I didn't mean to do that right here. I want to click on here. We'll choose 10. Hit OK. And then you can see you can even extrude an N-gon if you'd like to. And I was still in polygon mode before. If you wanted to, you could also use this tool with points. So now I'm in point mode. I still have this tool here. I think I'm going to reduce the offset to 0 for just, well, maybe we'll do something fun. Maybe we'll try a different amount of 15. I don't feel like we need the vertices selected. I'll hit OK. And you can see that it has extruded these points. They kind of look like abstract mountains, but you can use this to help you 3D model and add points to your mesh. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. If you'd like to be notified when new tutorials come out on 3D modeling tools, please hit like and subscribe. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next week on Ambient 3D Animations.